Hello students, we are going to discuss about drying problems. Next one, we are going to take specific heat of vapor from specific heat of gases and vapor at one atmospheric pressure graph. This figure shows that specific heat of gases and vapor at one atmospheric pressure. This graph also taken from unit operations of chemical engineering by McCabe and Smith. To refer that book, how to read specific heat of vapor at given temperature. What is a given temperature? TWB. TWB is nothing but outlet wet bulb temperature. That is equal to 102 degree Fahrenheit. So this is appendix 14 from unit operations of chemical engineering by McCabe and Smith. Are you clear on that? Okay. Yes. How to read specific heat of vapor from this graph? You should mark temperature 102 degree Fahrenheit in left side temperature scale. Then you should choose vapor component, that is water, for our problem to identify that component number in table. Refer the graph. Red color circle indicate water component number. In this table, 17 is a water number. You should mark at point 17 in this graph. First connect temperature 10 degree Fahrenheit point and point 17. Then extend the line up to specific heat scale at right side. Then you read specific heat of vapor from this graph at right side specific heat scale. Are you clear on that? Okay. From this graph, specific heat of vapor at 102 degree Fahrenheit, that is equal to 0.45 BTU per pound degree Fahrenheit. Next, we are going to take specific heat of liquid value. Which components are liquid in our problem? Water. Specific heat of water constant value. In terms of FES unit, specific heat of water, that is equal to 1 BTU per pound degree Fahrenheit. Are you clear on that? Okay. So the next parameter, rate of mass transfer. Rate of mass transfer m dot v is equal to m dot s into xA minus xB. Once you know m dot s and xA xB value, easily calculate m dot v value. M dot s is given data 2800, that is mass flow rate of solid. xA is the given data, initial moisture content 0.15. xB also given data, final moisture content 0.005. Both moisture contents are dry basis. So the finally we get m dot v is equal to 406 pound per hour. Next we are going to calculate heat duty value. I hope all of you watched my video about determination of length of dryer using rate concept. This equation taken from that video only. So the QT by m dot s is equal to CPS. These CPS values are given data, that is 0.52. TSB and TSA is nothing but solid inlet and outlet temperature. Outlet temperature 125, inlet temperature 80. XA is the initial moisture content 0.15. This is also given data. CPL, constant value, specific heat of liquid for our problem, water. TV is the vapor temperature. For this problem, vapor temperature should be taken as TWB. Why? Because TV and TWS both are equal 102 degree Fahrenheit. Then TSA, already I said, this is solid inlet temperature 80 degree Fahrenheit. XA is the initial moisture content 0.15. XB is the final moisture content 0.005. Lambda value, this is also taken from steam table, refer the previous slide, 1036, plus XB value final moisture content 0.005. CPL already I said specific heat of water for our problem, that is the liquid. So this is a constant value 1. TSB, this is solid final temperature 125 degree Fahrenheit. TV already I said that is equal to TWB. So wet bulb temperature at outlet condition, that is TWB 102 degree Fahrenheit. Then 0.15 is the current. Okay, so that is the initial moisture content. Final moisture content 0.005, that is XB. CPB, so specific heat of vapor taken from appendix 14. So from appendix 14, that is a graph of specific heat of gases and vapor. So from that graph, CPB values are 0.45. Then TVA is nothing but THA. THA means this is hot air outlet temperature. This is calculated value 137 degree Fahrenheit. Then TV value is already I said, that is equal to TWB. Are you clear on that? Okay. So the substitute all the value, find out QT by M dot S 179.3. So from this M dot S also given data, that is mass flow rate of solid. So multiply by M dot S, finally we get QT is equal to 502040 BTU per hour. So this is the heat duty value. Next we are going to take humid heat from psychrometric chart. This figure shows that psychrometric chart. How to read humid heat from psychrometric chart with the help of humidity. Humidity values are given in our problem. So what is the humidity value? HB is equal to 0.01. This is a given problem. So first step, you should mark humidity in y axis at the right side, that is 0.01. Then from HB, that is humidity value, you should draw a horizontal line up to humid heat versus humidity line. Are you clear or not? Okay. So up to this line at left side, from that meeting point you should draw a vertical line up to humid heat line in top of the psychrometric chart. In this chart, green color box indicate humid heat value. So from this graph, read a humid heat value. So here humid heat values are 0.245 BTU per pound degree Fahrenheit approximately. Now we are going to calculate flow rate of entering air. M dot G into 1 plus HB is equal to QT divided by CSB into THB minus THA. From this, M dot G is equal to QT divided by 1 plus HB into CSB into THB minus THA. From this expression, we want to calculate flow rate of entering air, that is M dot G. QT values are calculated value 502040, 1 plus HB values are given data. This is inlet humidity 0.01. Then humid heat value CSB, this is taken from humidity chart 0.245. Refer the previous slide. THB, hot air entering temperature, this is given data 260 degree Fahrenheit. THA, hot air outlet temperature, so this is calculated value 137 degree Fahrenheit. Students, keep in your mind THB, hot air entering, THA, hot air leaving. So they refer the previous slide, the counter flow temperature profile diagram. M dot G is equal to 16495 pound per hour. So next one we are going to calculate outlet. So the outlet humidity value, that is HA is equal to HB plus M dot B by M dot G. Here HB is known, that is inlet humidity. M dot B is already calculated value. M dot G also calculated value. Substitute here. Finally we get HA is equal to 0.0346 pound of water per pound of dry air. This is the this is also outlet humidity. Are you clear on that? Okay, students, keep in your mind, hot air entering temperature is a THB, hot air outlet temperature is a THE. That's why the humidity entering is a HB, humidity leaving is a HE. Are you clear on that? Okay, keep in your mind, based upon the hot air entering and the leaving notation, so the HE and the HBs are different. HB is entering humidity, HEA is leaving humidity. Then we are going to calculate area. Area formula, area is equal to m dot g by g. M dot g is nothing but, that is flow rate of air. G is nothing but mass velocity. So here, this area equation from mass velocity expression, mass velocity is equal to mass flow rate divided by area. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here m dot g is calculated value. Mass velocity is given data. Substitute here. Find out the area 23.5 feet square. So area is equal to pi d square by 4. This is the rotary dryer. So from that diameter is equal to 5.47 feet. I hope all of you watched my videos about determination of length of dryer using rate concept. From that video only I have taken this formula. This formula for FES unit, not SI unit. Next we are going to discuss about the length calculation. L is equal to QT by 0.125 pi D G power 0.67 del T bar. This is FES unit expression, where del T bar is equal to THB minus TWB minus of THA minus TWA divided by ln of THB minus TWB whole divided by THA minus TWB. Are you clear on that? Okay. For air water system, TWA is equal to TWB. Substitute all the values here. All temperatures are known value. Finally, we are going to calculate del T bar value. Del T bar is equal to, after substituting this temperature, 81.6 degree Fahrenheit. After that, we are going to use the length expression. Substitute QT value, that is 502040 divided by 0.125 into pi into this is the G power 0.67, that is 700. Diameter is a 5.47. Del T bar is a 81.6. Finally, we get a length value 35.5 feet. So, we want L by D ratio. Length is already calculated value 35.5. Diameter also calculated value. Substitute here. Find out L by D ratio 6.50. This is a reasonable value for rotary dryer design. Thank you for your attention. If you have any queries, post your question in WhatsApp group. I am ready to tell the answer. Thank you for your attention.